If Boeing are struggling to put together a new mid-sized aircraft, something a lot of airlines out there are asking for, well, then why don't they just slap some new wings and new engines on their existing Boeing 757? This is a question that I am getting very often on my channel, and it turns out that this is a question that Boeing themselves have asked not too long ago. So why isn't it happening? Stay tuned. Up until January 2020, Boeing was planning on releasing something that we got to know as the NMA, the new mid-sized aircraft. The idea behind that aircraft was to plug a hole in the Boeing passenger jet lineup, where the biggest of the Boeing 737 MAX series, the Boeing 737 MAX 10, at the moment will seat 230 passengers. But then, the next passenger jet is the Boeing 787-8, and it seats 359 passengers, so that's a pretty substantial gap. But that gap hasn't always been there. Boeing used to have the 757-200 that could seat up to 240 passengers, and the really long Boeing 757-300, which is actually the world's longest single-aisle aircraft, seating 280 passengers. And then came the Boeing 767, which in different length could seat anything between 245 and 375 passengers in a single class configuration. Now, the Boeing 767 is still being made, but only in a freighter version and a military refueling tanker version. Boeing stopped manufacturing the 757 back in 2004 because of a lack of demand, but that wasn't necessarily because the aircraft wasn't profitable anymore. It was just because after 9/11, there was a general downturn in the industry and there weren't enough orders in order to sustain continued manufacturing. That came as a big shock for a lot of people out there because the Boeing 757 had a lot of fans, and I consider myself to be one of them. I love the way that that aircraft looks. The Boeing 757 was really made to be able to operate out of some hot and high airports, and because of that, it had a lot of excess engine power, making it a very sporty aircraft to fly. It also was among the first aircraft that were equipped with EFIS screens and ACOS, and it had a really roomy cockpit, something that I, as a Boeing 737 pilot, would definitely appreciate. The airlines that were using the Boeing 757 generally tended to hold on to them for quite a long time, and a lot of the aircraft also found a second life as freighter towards the end of their life cycle. Turns out that those oversized engines produced an overall great performance, which suited well for cargo aircraft as well, but now the 757 have not been manufactured for many, many years, and the airlines are desperately looking for a replacement. A good example of an airline who has been actively asking for an aircraft of this size is Delta Airlines in the US. And the last time that they bought a new aircraft from Boeing was back in 2011, when they bought 100 Boeing 737-900ERs. Delta had been in active talks to Boeing about their new mid-sized aircraft, the NMA. That's likely why they didn't go out and buy a similar type aircraft from another manufacturer. But then in January 2020, Boeing froze all plans of the NMA. Remember, at that point, Boeing was fully committed to trying to sort out the Boeing 737 MAX crisis, and then after 2020 came COVID. So with the plans of the NMA now completely frozen, Delta instead went out and ordered Airbus 321 Neos. That aircraft could seat as many passengers as the Boeing 757-200 could, but it had a slightly shorter range. But Airbus will sort that out with a variant of the Airbus 321 called the XLR. And Delta right now is in talks with Boeing about purchasing Boeing 737 MAX 10s. So could Boeing potentially come up with something new centered around the old Boeing 757? Well, as it turns out, this is something that Boeing themselves seriously considered. When they dropped the plans for the NMA, the Boeing engineers looked into a possibility of a new version of the Boeing 757 called the 757 Plus. Now, it's unclear whether that version would have a completely new wing, but we do know that they were looking into a Boeing 767 that would be completely re-winged and re-engined. So why haven't Boeing gone ahead with either of those ideas? Well, there are many possible reasons, but let's start with the most obvious ones. It was now more than 18 years since Boeing stopped producing the Boeing 757. It is unclear whether or not Boeing even have the required toolings and jigs needed in order to restart production again. Bear in mind that this is not just about Boeing themselves. Boeing sources a lot of parts from external suppliers when they're building the Boeing 757, and those suppliers need certified and specialized tools in order to create those parts, and it's unclear whether or not they have kept those either. But of course, if there are enough financial incentives here, both the suppliers and Boeing themselves are going to overcome these obstacles, but it's going to come at a fairly steep price. But then we get to the next challenge in this idea, and that is the engines. In order for a new 757 to be financially viable, it has to have better per seat costs than very efficient new single-aisle aircraft like the 737 MAX or the Airbus A321neo. And the only real way that it can do that is by fitting the 757 with new, more efficient engines. But the problem here is that the engines that are available on the market today are either too big or too small. Boeing has been in talks with General Electric about the possibility of a new engine. General Electric has the GEnx engine, which is fitted to the 787 and also to the 747-8. In the case of the 747-8, the GEnx has a slightly smaller fan, but even that engine is way too big to be fitted onto the Boeing 757. There is also the CFM LEAP engine family that is fitted both to the 737 MAX and the Airbus A320neo family, and that engine was actually built on the basis of the GEnx engine. Those engines would be, in terms of size, engine diameter and weight, well fitted to fit under the wing of the 757. The problem though is that they don't have as much power as is needed, and it would be a possibility to maybe boost up the engine thrust a bit on those engines, but once again that is going to take a lot of time and money to do. There are other engine manufacturers as well, for example Pratt & Whitney, which have the geared turbofan engine, but the problem with that engine is that it has more or less the same kind of power as the LEAP engine family has, so it wouldn't help much. And then we have Rolls-Royce. Rolls-Royce is working on a completely new engine type called the ULTRAFAN. And the ULTRAFAN was actually looked at for the NMA aircraft back in the day. But ironically, Boeing didn't choose the Rolls-Royce ULTRAFAN because they wanted to launch the NMA quicker, and the ULTRAFAN was still under development at that point. But lately, Rolls-Royce has confirmed that they are again talking to Boeing, and Rolls-Royce will be starting testing of its ULTRAFAN engine very, very soon. However, this engine is a huge engine. It is way too big to fit under the wing of a Boeing 757. It's so big that it won't even fit under the wing of a Boeing 777X. Then there's a question of whether or not an updated Boeing 757 would need a new wing. Obviously, that's a cost issue, but there's a lot of financial gains that can be made by putting a new ultra-modern composite wing onto a new aircraft. That's why Boeing decided to do it on the Boeing 777X. However, as we've seen with the Boeing 777X, just re-winging an old aircraft type with a new wing is not necessarily a quick thing to do. The Boeing 777X was launched back in 2013, and it was supposed to go into service in 2020. Now it looks like it might be certified in 2024 to enter service in 2025. But to be fair, Boeing had to develop a brand new facility for composite wing manufacturing. So it is a possibility that the experience that they gained building the wing for the Boeing 787 and for the Boeing 777X might make it both cheaper and quicker to do it for a new updated Boeing 757 wing. So if finding and making the tooling and the jigs is possible, and developing a new engine is possible, and making a new wing for the aircraft is possible, is this still a good idea? Is it economical for Boeing to do? Well, we're going to get to that just after this very short message from my sponsor. This video is sponsored by Fabulous, the number one self-care app to help you build better habits and achieve your goals. Listen, I know that it's really easy to put yourself last in the queue when you have a family to take care of and a full-time job. I have always enjoyed my busy lifestyle, but I've found that lately it's become harder and harder to prioritize exercise, eating healthy and taking care of my body. But that was until I found Fabulous, which is a digital coach that uses behavioral science to help you to find good healthy habits and to actually stick to them. It is 100% personalized to your needs, and you can choose by different paths, for example, the habit tracker or dedicated programs. For me, having a routine is really important, and Fabulous helped me to start a new routine where I get up before everyone else in the family, I have a sip of water, and then I go out and I exercise, which is a great way to start the day. So if you want to start your own Fabulous ideal new daily routine, well then start by clicking on the link in the video description below or on the pinned comment. The 100 first of you who does that will get 25% off the Fabulous subscription, and I highly, highly recommend it. Well, in order for it to be worth it for Boeing to upgrade the Boeing 757, it would have to be financially more viable and better than developing a completely new design. That means it needs to be both cheaper and better. And neither of those is a given in this case, because Boeing has been putting out a lot of emphasis lately on a change they want to make in how they both build and design new aircraft, something they called the digital engineering revolution. Boeing hopes that using this new process, they will be able to launch an aircraft much, much both cheaper and quicker. And in order to do so, they have to involve the sub-manufacturers, the suppliers, not only in the actual supplying phase, but also in the design phase. The first time that Boeing actually used this new manufacturing philosophy was a military project called the T-7A Red Hawk Trainer. They did this together with Saab in Sweden, and Boeing boasted that by using this new digital engineering, they managed to get the aircraft from computer screen into the air in only 3 years. Now, building a single-engine, two-seater jet training aircraft is, of course, a completely different animal than to build a two-engine airliner that's seating over 200 people. So Boeing is not claiming that they would be able to do that in less than 3 years. But it begs the question that if they can now use this new design philosophy to maybe build a brand spanking new all-composite aircraft, is it really worth it to spend time re-engineering a Boeing 757, which is a very old design that they stopped making 18 years ago? Especially since we now know how long time it took to do the same thing for the Boeing 777. Of course, that question cannot be answered without also looking at the competition, because the competition is everything in this world. And when we say competition, obviously, we're talking about Airbus. If tomorrow Boeing were to announce that they are releasing a new 757 MAX or 757 Plus onto the market with maybe Delta as a launch customer, you can be absolutely sure that Airbus would not be just sitting there waiting, looking at a new competitor getting onto the marketplace. They would react in one way or another. And the way they would react is the same way that Boeing has reacted when Airbus has done this in the past. They would look at the possibility of making some of their existing types more efficient, or looking at a completely new design to counteract this threat. And that's a pretty big problem, because Airbus could quite easily pull off a re-wing project of their Airbus A321neo. And they could probably do that much quicker than Boeing could, because Airbus has already been working on a very similar project like this, something they call the Wings of Tomorrow, where they're looking at an out-of-autoclave, all-composite new wing structure that would be easier and cheaper to manufacture. In fact, in 2021, there were some sources saying that Airbus was indeed looking into a stretch version of the Airbus 321neo with a lighter wing, something that they might call the Airbus 322. And they could also do a very similar thing to the Airbus 320neo. Now, later in the year, Airbus did say that they were not about to launch that project after all. But the Wings of Tomorrow project is still ongoing, and you can be absolutely sure that if Boeing would launch a new project, so would Airbus, and they would do it very quickly. Finally, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, even if Boeing were to make a new Boeing 757 MAX or 757 Plus, it still wouldn't cover the gap in the passenger capacity between the 737 MAX and the 787. In order to do so, they will also need to do a re-engineer version of the Boeing 767. And of course, making two re-engineer versions, one of the 757 and of the 767, is completely out of the question. So finally, sadly, my conclusion is that there are many reasons why re-engineering and re-winging a Boeing 757 is not a very viable idea for Boeing. Even if they could find suitable, more powerful and more economic engines and put new wings on it, it's likely that a Boeing 757 MAX still wouldn't be quick enough to get into service, cheap enough to develop or even competitive enough against Airbus, and it wouldn't properly fill the gap that Boeing has between the MAX and the 787. So what will Boeing actually do? It's been more than 2 years now since they put the NMA project on ice, and after that they've been very quiet about their future plans. The few statements that they have made points towards a new aircraft, possibly towards the end of this decade. And in that case, it's likely going to be very similar to the NMA project. The problem Boeing now faces is whether or not they will put it off and wait for potentially more efficient engine types to be released, or if they're going to go ahead with the current engine technology that exists today. What we do know though is that Boeing has recently been hiring a lot of new engineers, and that is a good sign. Now, check out this video next, which is about the reason for the ongoing travel chaos that we're seeing right now. And if you want to support the work that I do here and on the Mentor Pilot channel, consider becoming part of my wonderful Patreon family or buy yourself some merch. Have an absolutely fantastic day, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.